What type of precedents do you think that the Kraft-Cadbury deal will set for other deals?
First, companies making the tender offers will be very careful about what they say. I think one of the mistakes that was made by Kraft was making a very straightforward, bold statement about what their intentions were going forward. Companies will be required to make their intentions known as to the business, as to the employees, and as to the effect that they'll have on the economy. And they'll be held to those. And if they don't say anything, there's a current proposal that they've got to make no changes for 12 months. If those are breached, there'll be sanctions. And I think companies will be much more careful about the public pronouncements they make. And I think they'll take these social factors into consideration rather than risk going through the political firestorm that Kraft has gone through.
Given the changing environment when it comes to hostile bids in the U.K., do you think that the U.K. will still be known as one of the most open markets to M&A?
100%. 100%. Because the U.K. is extremely important for them that they have foreign investment. In the absence of foreign investment, the country will suffer. So what's going on right now, it's a very fine balancing act between dealing with the political pressure that's come down because of the loss of jobs in connection with the Kraft and the broken promises, but also keeping the UK economy open for business and keeping it vibrant, because the UK economy really runs on foreign money coming in.
Do you think we might see any more legislation aimed at protecting targets in the UK?
It's possible. It's, you know, clearly the left has come out and said that they ought to have laws in place similar to CFIUS, which we have in the U.S., where there can be an ombudsman that could look at the transaction and see whether it's good for the English economy as a whole and good for the English people as a whole. I think that's probably a bridge too far at this point, and what you're going to see, again, are the social factors being brought into consideration, but not actually new legislation coming in that will require a separate body to judge the merits of a transaction.